Hey, welcome to my channel. If you've been curious about ZO skincare or you're looking for a solution for your melasma and acne, then this video is for you. I'm Lauren and I'm going to go through everything you need to know about ZO skincare and specifically the hydroquinone and the brightening products. I've been using ZO since January and I wanted to go through the first 3 month cycle of the hydroquinone before I shared my experience with you so I can really show you my results and share what you can expect on the products. In this video, I'm going to share why ZO skincare is unique, which products I use, and go into detail about each one and why they're beneficial for you, and then share my opinion of the products and how my skin reacted over the 3 months, and then I'm going to show my final results. So this video is going to be a pretty long one. I will leave timestamps with specific topics in the description box below. If you want to fast forward or skip around to what you're most interested in, feel free. All right, let's get started. ZO was founded by Dr. Zen Obagi, and you may have heard of the product line Obagi. That was his old product line, and he sold Obagi and then launched ZO Skincare using his new technology to restore skin health. So his products are meant for use by every gender, skin color, and ethnicity, and he really focuses on healthy skin and defines it in 6 different ways. So first, it's smooth in texture, it's firm and tight, even in color, hydrated, tolerant and strong, and free of disease. And ZO is different from a lot of other brands because traditionally treatments generally just address your skin's surface symptoms and they don't really improve the cellular function or the overall skin condition. So ZO targets skin at the cellular level to restore the health of the skin from the inside out. So like imagine a fixer-upper house. You have 2 options. You can either touch up the areas that need it most. This is like adding a moisturizer or even just putting on makeup that can disguise the issues, or you can completely tear it down and rebuild, which is what ZO would do. So you knock down the dysfunctional walls or the cells and rebuild from the foundation or the cellular level. And I mean, it's intense, but ZO is considered to be medical grade skincare, and medical grade means that you have to purchase them from a doctor or a med spa. You can purchase some of the products online from a doctor or a med spa if they have an online store, and I do have a discount code that I will link in my bio if you want to try any of the products from my med spa. But if you want to get on the full hydroquinone regimen, then you do need a consultation. And a lot of places now can do them virtually. So I do suggest getting a consult before you buy because you want to make sure you're on the exact products that will benefit your skin the most. All right, back to medical grade skincare. So why would you choose medical grade over just over the counter? And I feel like there are many brands out there that everyone swears are just as good as medical grade. And that very well may be true for some skin types, but the difference is that over the counter products are required by law to reduce the amount of active ingredients in their formulas. They do this because they want to make it to where even if the product is used incorrectly, it's not going to completely wreck your skin. And that means a lot of your skincare products are likely far too weak to treat your skin concerns. And this is especially true if you're battling melasma like me, where the over-the-counter products have 2% hydroquinone and they might help a little bit, but especially on hydroquinone, you want the guidance and you want to make sure that you're using them properly and you have someone monitoring your progress, and it's just not gonna happen over the counter. So I honestly have a lot of over-the-counter products that I love and I swear by, but none have really been effective in treating the pigmentation. So I was ready for the next level, and medical grade skincare products are thoroughly researched, tested, physician supervised, and FDA cleared for use because they contain a higher level of active ingredients. So they need to ensure that they will be safe for your skin concerns, but also be effective. Another great feature of medical grade products is that they offer a better delivery system to help the ingredients penetrate deeper into your skin and treat the core issue of your skin concerns, whereas over-the-counter products generally just treat the surface concerns. Like I mentioned earlier, it's like touching up a fixer-upper versus knocking it down and rebuilding. The reason I went on ZO is because I have melasma, which is pigmentation that mainly appears in women during the reproductive years. And mine is mild, but it's still one of those things in my routine that I am constantly working on. So I have melasma on my cheeks, my forehead, above my upper lip, and over my left brow, and I'm just over it. I would love to not have dark spots and pigmentation and acne scarring too, but that's a whole nother thing. So melasma is really hard to treat, and I've seen other people have amazing results from ZO, so I really wanted to try them myself. The ZO products that I ended up using work to treat the underlying causes of the melasma and not just bleach the pigmentation. And then I also wanted to treat my redness, my acne, and my fine lines. So I tested a lot of products from them. One other thing about pigmentation, with any other concern like sun damage, honestly, I would just say get a laser facial because you're gonna see great results really fast. And your skin can handle the heat of the laser. Unlike if you have melasma, which is activated from heat and hormones. So anything heat related can really aggravate your melasma. And if you ever see me outside, you know I'm gonna be wearing a hat or a visor and probably a ton of SPF. And I usually try to sit in the shade too because of the heat. So it's just one of those skin conditions that is hard to treat and you don't want it to come back, and there's no cure for melasma. It's like herpes where it can always reoccur, and you could even be the most careful person on the planet. Like, I am very aware of the heat and the sun around me and it still acts up. So it's really frustrating. Even if you're really careful, if your melasma is stimulated, and it can be stimulated from like hormonal changes, if you get pregnant, if you are on birth control. I mean, mine started when I was 27 and now I'm 34. So I've been dealing with it for a while. It's very frustrating. And I was ready for some real help with my melasma. Ingredients like hydroquinone are usually what you'll see people recommend when working to treat it. So I'm going to explain a little bit about what hydroquinone is. It's basically a skin lightening ingredient that is used to treat hyperpigmentation, melasma, freckles, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. And the ZO products use the 4%, which is ideal for the most natural results. You can only get that percentage from a physician. So you will see a lot of 2% hydroquinone on the market, like over the counter. And it'll work, but you're not going to see like peak results. But another thing that's interesting, and it's been studied, is that higher concentrations of hydroquinone aren't necessarily better. So if you see anything like 5% or more, you want to steer clear, because the studies show that people that use the higher percentage tend to develop more stubborn and difficult to treat hyperpigmentation over time. So it's such a fine line. But one big thing about hydroquinone is that you can't use it continually. So you're supposed to do pulse therapy, which according to my ZO skincare rep is 5 to 7 months max on hydroquinone. And then you switch to their other brightening products in between to make sure that your melanocyte pigment cells don't develop new pigment. And that's interesting, because I was under the impression that you aren't supposed to use hydroquinone longer than 3 months at a time, but if Dr. Obagi says 5 to 7 months, then good. I say the longer the better usually, because I want to just make it go away. So after the 5 to 7 months, you then taper off of hydroquinone and go into their maintenance mode. And then if you need, you go back on the hydroquinone, but only if it's necessary. It's one of those things that if you don't have your pigment come back right then, you don't need to use it again. So when should you see results from ZO Skincare? You'll notice the difference in your skin's texture, softness, and luminosity within days. And then if you're compliant with the protocol, you'll see a significant pigment improvement within 4 to 8 weeks, possibly sooner. And that was easier said than done, at least for me. It's very common for your skin to react when you start a new medical grade skincare routine with active ingredients like hydroquinone, and I was on their retinol, and I mean, even just tretinoin or alpha hydroxy or beta hydroxy acids, if your skin's sensitive. Reactions can be anything like redness, dryness, stinging, tightness, burning, swelling, flaking, and peeling. Those are all considered normal, and they're actually a good sign of your skin repair, but they really do suck. And I experienced every single one of those while I was using ZO. So that is part of the ZO protocol though. So they want to induce what they call a controlled and temporary therapeutic treatment period of acute inflammation to stimulate the body's repair process. And they really liked that my skin was super inflamed, because inducing the inflammation should help improve your skin's barrier function, cell cycle, it'll normalize your pigment cells, strengthen, stabilize the skin, and then just overall give you that general cell health. And they say it's normal for your skin to look worse before it gets better. Your skin will typically begin to acclimate to these products within 2 to 8 weeks, but it took me a very, very long time. And the hydrating cream was my saving grace most nights. I used it every day, to be honest. So I had my ZO rep on speed dial because my skin was so pissed. And she would say to think of this as the temporary ugly duckling phase. It's like getting your skin in shape. And if you're consistent, you're going to have this beautiful skin. And so she was very motivating for me. And she made me stay on the protocol, even though I really wanted to quit a lot. Like probably for most of the time I was on these products, I was really, really over it. Another thing with ZO is it's really expensive. So I wanted to see if I could supplement my non-ZO brands that I already trust and love in with the heavy hitting ZO products. And they said that I could, but you definitely want to be on both of the hydroquinone products together with the retinol or some sort of tretinoin from the doctor. Because Dr. Obagi created his system of hydroquinone bleaching and blending, which I'll explain a little bit later in this video, but they really want you on both of those products with their retinol. So initially I started with four products. In the morning and night, I used the Pigment Control Cream, and this contains the 4% hydroquinone and also glycolic acid. And the two ingredients together works to suppress and inhibit new pigment from forming, and it will start to bleach existing pigment on the surface of your skin. The reason you need to use this twice a day is because hydroquinone has a short lifespan in the skin, so you want to ensure you're getting as much suppression as possible to those pigmented cells. And then at night, I also applied their Pigment Control Blending Cream, which also has 4% hydroquinone, but this needs to be combined with the retinoid to be effective. So it has a few ingredients that work with the retinoid that help it penetrate deeper into the skin's dermis. And this forces the pigment cells to be distributed in horizontal patterns, and then that's what evens out any blotchiness or really just evens out your skin tone to make it look more natural instead of giving you that bleached look that can happen with hydroquinone. So the first month I started with just adding the hydroquinone, and then I also included the retinol and the hydrating cream, which, where's that? This guy. This is something I needed to use daily because the retinol is no joke. My skin was so upset. I mean, really, I've had reactions to hydroquinone in the past and like breakout reactions, and then adding the retinol on top of it, it was a lot. So I didn't think I'd experience that because my skin was already acclimated to my other retinol, but it was really bad. So after struggling with the breakouts and the dryness for a month, I contacted my ZO rep and I told her my concerns because I was having a lot of trouble getting the products to blend in. So I would apply one, I would rub it in, I'd apply the second one, rub it in. And it was like this white face mask, and I would be rubbing and rubbing and rubbing for minutes. And then my skin would be bright red for like 2 hours after I applied the nighttime products. So she told me that the blending issues, like getting it to blend into my skin, is probably because I have dead skin that needs to be sloughed off, and she said the sensitivity is normal. So she ended up putting me on the entire ZO protocol, which it was a lot, but I'm glad because I did want faster results and I didn't want to have these acne purgy breakouts. So if this would help, then I was all for it. It's a lot of products. I'm going to try to simplify this routine for you as much as possible. But honestly, this was the most extensive skincare routine I've ever used. So let's go. So the first thing I did was the Getting Skin Ready routine. So you use their cleanser and then their exfoliator. This is a physical scrub. And then the peel pads. And these work together to normalize your skin's function and then restore the overall skin health. Dr. Obagi's whole thing is that sebum or oil is one of our top enemies in our skin because it leads to inflammation, which causes pigment disorders, acne, redness, texture, enlarged pores, etc. I never considered myself super oily. I was always combo, but Dr. Obagi's rule of thumb is that if you can see a pore, then there's oil in it. So his cleansing system is proven to reduce sebum production by 41% in just 4 weeks. So if me having oil on my face is going to cause all of these other issues, then I was all for getting on this system. So I'm going to share all the products I use with a little bit of info about each one and then also the price. The Gentle Cleanser, this is $45, and it's actually a really great size. It's 6.7 fluid ounces. It smells so good, and it gets really nice and foamy, and it doesn't leave your skin feeling stripped. It does kind of burn your eyes, though, so just beware, but I really did enjoy this cleanser. And then I was using the exfoliating polish every day. So this is a scrub, and it removes dead skin cells, and it makes you look super glowy, but it also enhances the product penetration of other products. So this scrub is $67, and It is pretty abrasive. So for days when I was extra sensitive, I would add it to my cleanser and just scrub with them together because it was just sometimes it was a lot. But most of the time I use this alone and I really love this. This is probably one of my favorite face scrubs I've ever used. It makes your skin look incredible. This is what it looks like, by the way. So it's like this blue. Oh, and look at how much I have left. So this is $67, but I mean, it's been 6 months and it's still holding strong. I probably have half of this tube left. So next I would use Thayer's toner because I just love it and it makes me happy. And then I would go in with the oil control pads. These are $62 and you get 60 pads in this. These are to help normalize oil production and then also reduce inflammation. These are a little abrasive and they made my face feel cold and tingly. So when I would go in with the next steps, it felt extra cooling. But I actually really enjoyed these and there's so much liquid in this that I would use one side of the pad in the morning and then the other side of the pad at night. And then I went in with the enzymatic peel. This is $72. So this is an enzyme lotion. So this is what this looks like. So it looks like a watery light lotion. And what this does is it basically acts like a Pac-Man. So it breaks up existing pigment, it helps with dry, flaky skin, it prevents clogged pores, and it smooths and softens texture, and it feels so good. This is probably my favorite product out of the whole bunch. I absolutely love this. Highly recommend this one. Yes, it's pricey, but I still have a lot left. Then I would apply the pigment control cream. So this is $66 and I still have a lot of product left. So I started using this on January 21st and there's still, it feels like it's up to here. So this lasts such a long time. All of these products really do. And so then I would go in with the Daily Power Defense and this is basically your moisturizer, but it's so much more than that. So it's a skin strengthening multivitamin repair lotion. It's basically a 5-in-1 product that offers DNA repair, boost collagen, it gives your natural hyaluronic acid a boost, it hydrates from within, replenishes lipids, and it strengthens your skin barrier. So it's supposed to help with reducing any sensitivities, and it also helps with aging. So it's an antioxidant. I mean, it's literally like your everything in one lotion, but it is expensive. It's $150, and I still have a lot of product left in this too. So these products last for months and I was using them daily. I didn't really skip anything. I mean, I'm very impressed with how long everything lasted, especially for the price point. So then I went in with Rosatrol and this is to try to help my redness. This is $88 and this is a treatment serum that reduces redness, inflammation, decreased cellular renewal, excess sebum, vascular degeneration. I mean, I really didn't notice the difference from this one, to be honest. I probably wouldn't recommend this one. It really didn't help with any redness. Plus, my skin was inflamed the whole time I was on this protocol. So I was hoping this would help with that and it didn't. All right. And then last, I tested two of their sunscreens. I don't know if they have more than two, but I tested the Smart Tone Broad Spectrum. And this one's interesting because it looks beige, but then when you rub it in, so it's Smart Tone. So it actually turns to your skin tone, maybe a little bit darker. Pretty cool. This one just stayed greasy and tacky on my face all day. So then I switched to their sunscreen primer and this one was more mattifying, but I mean, they're so expensive. I don't really love spending that much on a sunscreen, so I probably wouldn't repurchase either of the sunscreens. And then at night, I would wash as usual, use my Thayer's toner, just make sure all of my makeup was off. Then I would use the other side of the acne pad. And we bumped up using the acne pads to twice a day after a month because I was breaking out so badly. And I do like that because I was wasting a lot of pads using one a day, so that worked out well. And then I would use the enzymatic peel. And then this is when you go in with the pigment control and then the pigment control blending cream. This is $64. And you would mix this with the wrinkle and texture repair retinol. This is $145, but there's still so much left. And then you go back in with the Daily Power Defense and the Rosatrol. And then most nights I would use the hydrating cream again, which is, I think it's $53, but the hydrating cream is an epidermal repair and healing cream. So it basically gives you like that instant boost of comfort and then it also helps support your skin. So this is what they use after like laser facials and just it's a very healing moisturizer. but it is a little bit thick to use during the day. So I really only use it at night or on days when I was wearing no makeup and I knew I wasn't leaving the house. But honestly, I would wake up in the morning and that's when I wanted to put the hydrating cream on the most because my skin felt dry, flaky. I had whiteheads all over. It was really frustrating. On days when I was super broken out, I would use the complexion clearing mask, which is, where is it? So this guy. And this is designed to be a pore detox. It removes dirt and oil. This has 10% sulfur, which is an antibacterial. It helps treat acne and reduce oil production. And then you can use this 1 to 3 times a week as a mask or a spot treatment, depending on how you need it. It is a little bit drying, so I usually just use it as a spot treatment. And yeah, that's a lot of product. Applying this many products really isn't easy or fun. And I had a hard time rubbing and blending everything in. So my rep said it was actually good because Dr. Obagi wants you to massage your skin for a few minutes after you apply your products. And they did eventually blend in. The massage helped. But one thing that's nice is you don't have to wait for them to dry before you apply the next one. Otherwise, I would just be doing skincare all day. So that was really helpful to know. Once I went on the full protocol, my skin was still really red and irritated. Basically, the whole time I was doing this regimen. So my skin was sensitive and unhappy for months, and it was really frustrating. I'd wake up with like small whiteheads, and I would pop them, and then I would have a red mark for days, and I didn't want to wear makeup, and I didn't want to take any photos or film videos, and wearing a mask definitely didn't help anything. It was very, very frustrating, and my skin was mad for months, which I've never experienced that before. So just, this is not for the faint of heart. If you are really trying to treat your melasma, I would say this is worth it. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't do this again. It definitely made a difference though. I am so impressed with how amazing my skin looked at the end. But it wasn't long lasting. Like, I would have a good day and then 3 bad days. So I would get to see my results briefly and I'd be really happy, and then I'd have to wear a mask or do something, and then it was just, my skin was aggravated again and my skin barrier was out of whack, and then it would be bad again. So it was like, it was really hard and it was really frustrating, but I mean, the results speak for themselves. They definitely work. I was taking pictures almost every week, and my melasma improved a lot, and my acne spots are a lot better. Then I started phasing out of the hydroquinone, and you want to make sure that you never stop using hydroquinone cold turkey because the pigment can rebound and it can actually be worse. So you gradually wean off of the hydroquinone. So my final after photos are when I started to wean off the hydroquinone after my full third month of being on it. And when you're weaning off, you want to do like cut back to 3 days and then cut back to 2 days, and then slowly you'll just end up being off of it and then you're done. But when you're weaning off of them, ZO wants you to get on their other non-hydroquinone brightening products. So they have Bright Alive and then the Retinol Skin Brightener. And then you also use the other retinol, so one in the morning, one at night, the wrinkle and texture repair. And all three of those products are important in the maintenance mode of the ZO skincare because they're taking the place of the hydroquinone products. And I was so over it at that point. So Bright Alive is basically a non-hydroquinone skin bleacher, and this replaces the pigment control cream. So as you're weaning off of the pigment control cream in the morning and at night, this is when you start incorporating this one. And you want to do this because it continues to suppress the melanocytes, and then your skin will be more stable once all of the hydroquinone is gone. And then the Retinol Skin Brightener contains that epidermal delivery system. So the wrinkle texture repair is the dermal delivery, and then this one is the epidermal delivery, and this ensures that you continue to evenly distribute the melanin in the skin and provide that blended look. And they do recommend using both retinols because you want to target each layer specifically. So if you only have one, it's like you're missing a piece of the ZO puzzle and you could result in some pigment reoccurring. If you don't want to use the hydroquinone or if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, ZO also has a 10% vitamin C serum, or you could use Bright Alive. It's safe for pregnancy. And then another thing I've always wondered is if I'm using bleaching products, can I also use self-tanner, or is it going to interfere? And fortunately you can, but it's not going to last as long because you are doing such intense exfoliation every day, and my face was really red the whole time I was on this protocol. So I didn't really use any self-tanner for months on my face, but that was good to know, I guess. I mean, I didn't really need it. Anything else? I feel like that was a lot of information. I mean, this is also a lot of products, but ZO is definitely not for the faint of heart. If you are really ready to invest in your skincare routine and really focus on your melasma, I do recommend it. I saw great results, but this isn't a fun skincare routine. This is one that you're like, all right, I gotta go do my skincare. You have to like mentally prepare yourself for it because, I mean, it is hardcore. So if you have any questions, please leave them below in the comment section or message me on Instagram at LaurenArrowBeauty. And then if you want to try any of these products, I will leave my MedSpa's information below. You get a discount if you mention me, which is cool because they're so expensive and any discount helps. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it informative. And if you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I would love to see you next time.